Hello, Steve. Harmless Rebel. This is Carsten, back again from Ermelo Corner. I'm here to make a response for your 100 subscribers contest, Steve. Congratulations. Well, cheers.
Have a little DAD beer.
Yeah. Well, I'm in a little conflict with myself about doing this response for your contest, because your contest questions was tell about an album that have changed your life, and also tell about a concert or music event that have changed your life. But I think it's a very, very big word, changed your life, because I haven't really had any albums or concert experience that have changed my life. I've always been the same guy, even though I have started to listen to different styles of music. Just to give it an example, when I started to listen to the Depeche Mode back in the day, I didn't start wearing black dresses and black shadows are around my eyes and stuff like that. And again, when I became a very, very big fan of Prince, I didn't start to dress like him or something like that, or change my styles. I have always been the same guy, even though I have listened to different styles of music, so I can't really say that I have an album or something that had changed my life, so I really don't know if I should do this, but I want to support your channel, because we have spoken a lot, not spoken, but we have commented on each other's videos and stuff like that. So I really wanted to come by here and say congratulations. That's really, really great. But just to do something. Well, by the way, if it's possible to hear, we are listening to Godsmack, Awake. And man, I really hope I could get their new album, 1000 Horsepowers. But I don't believe it's available in Denmark yet. So I have to settle for one of the old albums. But just to share something with you guys, maybe I should start to tell you how I became a Prince fan. And again, Prince fan is also a very, very big word, because I don't really listen to his music anymore. It's about 10 years ago, 10 years since I have been a very, very big fan, but he's always there, kind of, and I like his early stuff up until the mid-90s and something like that, so I still like very much of his music, but I just don't really listen to it that much anymore. I'm kind of up in a different place. Like you can hear right now, I just need some heavy. So, well, let me just tell you about Prince anyway. Maybe I should also share with you that I have always been this big music collector. I've always been this athlete that have done a lot of sports and stuff like that. So music has always been things, or have been something I have relaxed to, and I haven't been that big collector until in my mid-20s. I bought a CD once in a while and stuff like that. But I didn't start to really collect music until my my first relationship with my first girlfriend. When we broke up and I was in my mid-20s, then I really started to go deep into music and really collect music. And so that thing about Prince, I haven't always bought all of his albums. It wasn't until, as I said, in my mid-20s, I saw the Purple Rain movie together with my older brother in the late 80s or something like that, and I really really liked it, and that that made me think that wow, this guy can really perform on stage, and there was something about this little short dude riding around on this cool purple motorbike that I really really liked. So I started to listen to him. My older brother had a lot of his albums and stuff like that, so I could listen to his music. And then I also saw the live concert, his Love Sexy tour, from his Love Sexy tour, and that's an absolutely fantastic concert. It's probably the best show I have seen on DVD. I haven't seen that show live. And unfortunately, I don't have that anymore. I had it on VHS, but I don't have it anymore. But I'll still show a clip up in the corner here from that show. And that also made me think, wow, this guy, he's absolutely fantastic. So I listened to a lot of his music then, but it wasn't until he came out with the Sign of the Times album. When I got this on CD back then, I believe it was. I can't remember if my brother had this on LP too, and I listened to it, and then I got it on CD. But this made me become a very, 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 very big fan, and I started to buy all his earlier stuff on CD back then. And about 10 years went, where I was a very very big fan. I just had to have everything that he made and stuff like that, and I would probably take some pictures with my Prince collections. I would post also. So around the 10 years of my life, I was a very very big Prince fan, and again, I listened to everything else, but I was crazy about Prince for a big part of my life. But again, it didn't really change me. I've always been the same guy, even though I like Prince and things like that. Because there wasn't a lot of my friends that listened to Prince or even liked him, so I always listened to Prince myself. So yeah. I don't know if this. I probably don't qualify for the contest, and that's fine with me. I just wanted, like I said, to come by and say. Congratulations with your 100 subscribers. So Steve, cheers again, my friend. And have a nice weekend, everyone. Bye bye.